Okay, today we're working on a 2002 Chevy Venture van with a 3.4 liter V6 engine, otherwise known as a 3400 SFI. And we're going to be flushing the cooling system out. And there's several ways of doing that. I think probably the easiest way to do in this van, I usually like to hook up to the heater hoses in the back, disconnecting or accessing one of the heater hoses at the firewall. But being this being a van, it's kind of harder to get up back there. So this should work right here. So we're gonna disconnect the hose from here. I'm gonna place some water hose so we can flush the system. And of course, you want to do this when the engine is it's cool. You don't want to do it while it's hot. So you need to let it cool down. We want to drain from the cooling system. And usually the best way to do that is we open up the petcock, the valve at the bottom of the radiator. In this vehicle, it's located right here below the overflow reservoir, straight down at the bottom of the radiator. You can drain it off with a suitable container under there. What I like doing, I like having a return hose to a big container to gather the antifreeze. And then, so I have it going one way. When I turn the heat, just turn the key on, engine off, and turn the heat full blast and all the way to hot, so we can flush the the heater core as well. And I'm having a little leak here, but this is clean water here. So we got some water going into here, and the flushing out the antifreeze out of the other hose. And then we'll do it the other way around. We'll switch it, back flush it, and do it from the radiator as well. Okay, so we'll do this until we get clean water coming out of the other end. And then we'll switch the connection and repeat the steps. And then we'll do it from the radiator. We'll show you how to do it to connect to the radiator as well. Okay, for the radiator connection, I use one of the pieces that come in a radiator flush set. You can get from different brands, and it hooks on to the radiator. It makes a tight fit there. And then I usually connect a hose here. I don't have my regular setup here, so I'll connect something here rigged up the water going into the radiator, and rigged up a second hose coming out of here into a large container to get the old antifreeze out of there. We don't want to throw that on the ground, and that'll kill pets and livestock and chupacabras, assorted animals. So and it'll mess up the environment. So we'll run this until we get a clean flow into the container, which looks like we already did. And this one was bad. This is real bad. This was left way beyond the time where it should have been flushed. This could have been the original orange antifreeze that normally comes with the GMs of this era, and it makes a real mess. So yeah, let's go ahead and close that off, and we'll back flush it again. Okay, so flush this back the other way, twist the hoses, and water's coming out clean now. So we did it all the different ways, all the three different ways. So we're pretty much set to refill the system. And let's not forget to empty out, flush, and refill our overflow reservoir. We want to make sure to top off the cooling system. We want to make sure our radiator cock, pet cock down there, it's closed. And then we'll top it off and get the engine running. And with the radiator cap off, once it warms up, keep topping it off. And my favorite, there's several ways of doing it. My favorite way of accomplishing it is with something like this. I put together with a funnel, and this is a part of a kit for flushing the cooling system, and that fits. This fits tightly into the radiator, and keeps it up like this, so that it brings the level of coolant up higher than the radiator. So as the engine warms up and takes in some more fluid, you're able to remove the air, the trapped air that's in there, and you can raise the RPMs slightly, and then you're able to put some more fluid in there. And then also, this engine has a couple of places to burp any trapped bubbles that may be in there, trapped air. This is one of them, and there's another here by this other small holes. There's another one there. That those two places, once the engine, it's the assist of the cooling system is pressurized, you can actually use a socket and slowly open up this little valve here. There's two little valves, this brass valves, and you're able to bleed the air out of the system. It's on top of the thermostat cover here, and right here, on the other side right here, next to this hose. So that's the actual way of bleeding the air out of the system. And check for leaks, and then you should be good to go. And I think that'll be it for this video. Thanks for watching. Hopefully this video was helpful. And please don't forget to thumbs up, subscribe, and share, and like and share. And as always, try to stay clean. Just try.